Turaki. I'm a writer and I'm a filmmaker. I had the privilege of working, or rather teaching, at TACK Academy.
TACK Academy is an initiative to empower filmmakers, or would-be filmmakers, people who are interested in telling stories. We provide training, free training, and mentorship. Basically, that's what TACK Film Academy is about.
It's an initiative that endeavors to give back to the society, to instill value in people at no cost.
TACK has been just more than a school to me.
We have a lot of people in our society, young people especially, you know, who are gifted and talented, and all they need to achieve their dreams and their visions is just someone to train them, to bring out the best in them.
It levels the playing ground, you know, and it makes these skills accessible for people, for anybody that has the desire and the passion to be able to tell stories in this way.
I saw the advert on the social media and I applied.
I heard about TACK Academy from a friend of mine.
TACK Film Academy, to me, it's not only a place to learn, it is actually a hope.
It has been church for me. It has been family to me. I've had myself find healing through TACK. I found myself find direction through TACK. I found purpose through TACK. You know, sometimes it's not like you don't know what your purpose is, but you somehow need a definition for it. And coming here on a daily basis, sometimes we come to class and it's not like we talk about film or the making of film. Sometimes we just talk about ourselves.
Coming to TACK was really a transformation for me.
The beauty of coming to TACK and the surprising part of it is we never paid for it.
Come to this place, you don't just come to class to see if you're living a rented apartment somewhere to your family house.
A lot have happened to my life. I didn't quite envisage that the training was going to be this big.
I've had a lot of experiences, beautiful and amazing experiences, from the people I've met, to our classes, to our instructors. It's been an amazing journey. One of the things I like particularly about TACK Academy is the way our classes go. It's not conventional, it's not the normal conventional class where somebody just stands and commands or teaches. Our instructors give us opportunities to express ourselves, to explore, to share what we think.
And these moments have gone a long way in shaping me forever.
And I think that's very, very wonderful. I think it's a thing our educational sector should adopt, so people can see how they feel about certain topics or subjects.
I have learned a lot from different resource persons that have taken us in different courses. Most notably, the directing part, the directing class we had that was more practical, where we had a short film shoot for spoken word poetry titled Tomorrow Never Came. It was a huge experience.
Me gida zaka fita ne?
Eh zan fita ga yara ki sun garin sai hankali.
Amma ka san ba abin cha a gidan nan ko?
Na sani mana. A sai kin sake faɗa ni a ce sai zan fitan nemo ba.
Abinda ka ce shakaran jiya kenan, ka ce jiya yanzu kana son mu yi ya kenan.
To ni kina so in je in yi sata ne?
Ai ban ce ka je kai sata ba.
To ya ki dinga mun nan magana.
Mama, asa Aisha makaranta.
Ke kuma sai me? In ga miki tala maza, in ga miki makarantar kyauta ne. Kina da kudi ne?
Baba ni ma na so sa.
Ke rufa mu asiri. Makaranta na masu kudi ne. Doki tallake tafi.
TACK. Mama said we were poor. Baba reiterated her words as its tweeting pangs met the rumblings in my belly. Go to the highway, they said. Go sell these edible wares so we can live and not die in hunger's fear. But we do not know if tomorrow will be fair. But tomorrow never came, cause I died today. My feet run meters far and near under the scorching blaze of sun rays, fiercely, profusely running after the cruel passenger who never dropped my money but went away with my artillery. Well, he wasn't the first to do that to me. My pulsated heart jumped to my chest, wheezing and gasping for air, still not one word sold. On and on it went. I was the fastest racer that never won a medal, either in front of my cohorts or in a national stadium, but I always had one medal waiting back at home for me. It was either a slap or a bad save, for a smile, for a good one. And there was Abu. He was the boy that made my body flush with ticklish sensations only you would know. His father also told him that they were poor. My son, go sell some artillery so we can feed. Abu was my partner in this business of race, wares and otherwise. And on days the race seemed futile, we go into the bush, take off our clothes, lie on the grass, and do what we see Mama and Baba do at night. They taught Miriam, Sule, Sadiq, Khadija, Ibrahim, Musa, Hafsat, and I were asleep. We sometimes raise our heads from the dark cold floor in our half-lit room. We peep at how Baba fights with Mama on the rising and falling motion. We hear Mama's shout, yet no tears in her eyes. Strangely, the feeling wasn't like when Baba beats Mama up. The feeling was soothing and chilly on my body. So when Abu came on me, it was no shock. But I had seen Baba jack on Mama many times like a halting horse in battle. You know, Abu was 12 and I 10. Whatever we thought we were doing felt both painful and sweet. I felt like a grown-up because my face was always covered in grotesque colors and lines Mama painted. She said it made me beautiful and attractive to travelers, so they buy from me and not the other girls. But little did she know that I was only beautiful in Abu's eyes. But today I died. As I raced through a racing car trying to get my 15 naira from the atelier passenger boat, I was crushed by another racing car I didn't see coming. Today I died. But I do not worry for my dead, cause dying is life to me, living was dead. I only fear that my spirit will know no rest, because now Miriam would have to continue the family's business of race and wares. And I fear even her and many others like me may never see the light of tomorrow. For today, they may also die.
Well, talking about education, for us, the way we look at it is to just, if we find interest, right, and as long as we can communicate, then I think there's room for us to improve one another. Education, yeah, it's not just that we are sitting here and then dishing out knowledge or skill. There's so much in being together with the other people. So we even learn from the students also. So it's, we're not saying, okay, this is the limit to what, to who we can take in. As long as you understand our language and we understand your own language, fine and good.
this place is a production house. We want to have you. We'll be having a training and I want you to come and get trained. The next thing on my mind was like how much, and I was thinking as a couple I can't afford, because I've been seeing prices of other people training filmmakers. It's really outrageous. So he told me for free. I still couldn't believe it. I was like, for free? And he said yes.
On personal level, my knowledge base have been expanded, and I'm quite impressed with the person I'm becoming as a result of the training.
It has been a hospital.
I did not pay anything, it was free. And there were, it's not just the training, there were other perks that came with the training. Like, we had to be provided with free meals and study materials and free practical training. And the training is even streamlined to meet our needs and our areas of interest, to like fashion us in, because it encompasses the diverse areas in filmmaking.
Come on, we didn't pay anything. Why would you give people who are coming to you for training, free training, and we're still getting fed? Everybody's being fed. Like, I didn't know what it was about. At a point, I was afraid that what's going on? Like, I can't explain it.
People place value in things and not in people, in humans. So we are here to change the narrative. We are here to cultivate a new spirit. And that is that we don't compete, we complete. So that's the what we're cultivating in our students and those who come around, that there's a need for us to build and create a better society for the next generation. So that's why we do this.
Hello?
Aika. Kamike Namaka. Ako.
Good afternoon. My name is Ako. Ako Onoja. I'm a lawyer by profession and I want to become an actor.
I am a prophet. A prophet by birth and inclination.
Are you prepared for it?
Echemaka kuna federal. Echemo patake chetake ubukedeni ni. But make no mistake, if I find your professional conduct unsatisfactory, omi acheni jo dutu na neko yu koloki den. Ebola na kai.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So, what makes you think you are best fit for Tochukwu, even though he's supposed to be seriously underweight?
Saka iya pasarawa a Hausa. Oh my God, my pocket jar town is like my blue river. Wala mi cheteti. Ogicho kidungi kache machi moton.
Ajogu kebutu maku. E shoka kini. Ina la tu kidomo kete neke kame.
Deju e kwame. Kego mi. Uwe nakai. E obabe edo. Edon.
Iko kamadu li ajogbe. Mama ya kene maskulu iko yejubogo mama odu tipu ojo odu eligeno
Dodo na na majo da bia.
From what we've seen so far, they are now beginning to see that if we continue to maintain this attitude of being in competition, we will never have, we'll never live in peace. Here in ATATAK, we have our slogan, we don't compete, we complete. The program runs for 16 weeks, and we normally have classes on Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays, three times in a week. The first batch, we graduated 14 students, and they shot four short films. We provide feeding because looking at coming to school and having to go look for food, I think that would be a distraction. And then there's something about eating together with people. That camaraderie is cultivated. You're building a community. And we feel that's what it should be.